Welcome to Everyday Cooking. Today we are going to see a special Pongal time curry. For the curry we need 1/4 cup of chickpeas, 1/4 cup of field beans, 1/4 cup of green peas and 1/4 cup of groundnuts. I'm using dried ones here, so I'm going to soak this in water. If you are using fresh ones, you can use it directly. Groundnuts will get soft quickly and will also get cooked quickly, so you have to soak it separately. Add enough water, everything should get completely immersed. We are going to leave this overnight. After about 7 to 8 hours, this has become soft. As I said earlier, we are going to cook the groundnuts separately. Add the soaked chickpeas, green peas and field beans in a pressure cooker along with the water. As this is not completely immersed, you can add a little extra water. Add the required amount of salt. Pressure cook this for 3 to 4 whistles. This is ready. Set this aside. Next, let us cook the groundnuts. If necessary, add some water. To this, add the required amount of salt. And pressure cook this for 2 to 3 whistles. Groundnuts are also ready. Next, let us prepare the masala. For the masala, we need 1/2 medium sized coconut. You have to chop them into pieces. To this, add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of chili powder, and 3 teaspoons of coriander powder. First, let us grind this without water. Grind this as fine as possible and then add water. You can add around 1/4 cup of water or adjust the water according to the need. Now grind this into a fine paste. For every coconut based masala, dry grind it first and then add some water and grind it. This way you'll get a very fine paste. So here the masala is ready. Let us transfer this into a pan or a kadai. To this, add 1 cup of water and 1 chopped drumstick. We need to cook the drumsticks now, so add enough water and close this and cook until they become soft. Once the drumsticks are ready, you can add the cooked groundnuts and also the chickpeas, green peas and field beans. Soak a lemon-sized tamarind in 1 cup of water for about 10 minutes. Dissolve it, filter it and add it into this. Taste for salt, if needed you can add it. Cook this in medium flame until you get the curry consistency. Finally, your curry has to be like this. To this, let us add some chopped coriander leaves. The curry is ready. Our next step is tempering. For the tempering, I am going to use Idayam sesame oil. You can add around 1 tablespoon of oil. Once the oil is hot enough, you can add 1/2 a teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 a teaspoon of split black gram. Once the mustard starts popping, add 1/2 a teaspoon of cumin seeds and few curry leaves. And here everything got fried well, so our tempering is ready. Let us add this into the curry. You can have this curry along with rice, roti, chapatis and any kind of breads. So do try this simple and delicious curry. Hope you like the recipe. We'll join you in another interesting recipe. Do like, share and comment our videos and don't forget to subscribe our channel.